talk to us about his predictions for the future of mathematical statistics.
First of all, I'd like to say that I'm very grateful to organizers since this invitation allows me to reflect on my work for a while. Hopefully, this reflection is of interest from someone more than me. In this presentation, I'd like to say something about mathematical finance and try to see which is the relationship with our discussion in the future of new challenges of mathematical statistics. Now we are in Dublin, Ireland, and I'm from Barcelona, Spain. Both countries have some similarities. For instance, both countries know how to build a speculative bubble in real estate and what happens when the bubble bursts. The current economic crisis caused to many people their saving, their jobs, and their homes. But in any case, I would like to say that mathematical statistics still has a fundamental role to play in the world of finance. In my talk, there will be three parts. First of all, I will talk about statistics and society, trying to identify what society thinks of statistics. Then I will take a little bit about modern financial markets. And the best thing to say is that the basic model for modern financial markets is really simple, but at the main time it's also wrong, and then more advanced models are needed, and perhaps this can be our work. And finally, I would like to say some words on the credibility of science, because I believe that this is related to the current crisis. In order to see what society is thinking of us, it's valuable to remember the World Statistic Day, declared by United Nations Statistical Division on 20th October of 2010. And this allows us to grasp what society is thinking of us. In their own works, the proposed World Statistic Day aims to raise awareness of the many contribution of official statistics on the premise of the core values of service, integrity, and professionalism. Remark that the World Statistic Day is the day of official statistics. Then this is what society is thinking of statistics, is official statistics. And remark also in the logo of the World Statistic Day, the values of service, professionalism, and integrity. I believe that professionalism and integrity may be valuable for financial markets. Of course, statistics go beyond the official statistics, and it's basic in research in many, many areas. And I remember what science in 1984 tried to identify that 20 more important advances in science in the 20th century and select the Pearson test as one of these 20 more important advances. In the early of the 20th century, the English school, that means Pearson, Fisher, and a student, realized that to take good decisions, it's important to quantify the uncertainty in the information we extract from data. In some sense, this is the logical of 95% that we often use, and this is the basis of the empirical reasoning, and I think this gives us some credibility. And the perception of the society about the statistics is important in the labor market. In fact, the task assigned to statisticians, as well as their salaries or the new job opportunities, depends on the perception of the society. And some people think that the statistical work is objective, but rather elementary and automatic. In fact, indeed, people think that they can dispense from with people and it's enough to have appropriate software. We have made case of the brain rather than the computer. And this, in a article of significance in 210, the title of the article was "Don't buy programs, but hire people." And I believe this is, I believe that we have credibility, but at my time, our weakness is that people assume that the statistics can be elementary. And of course, we didn't think so. But at the main time, banks attract specialists in quantitative methods, both engineers, physics, or mathematics. And they also attract statisticians, but a less extent. And perhaps we can modify this perception through education. I would like to mention Chao Li Meng, that is in a paper on 209, talks about the importance of the education in statistics and the danger of unqualified people take this, this work for us. I believe that the future of the statistics will depend on today's students. We would like to do prediction about the future. Perhaps the best is try to modify the present through the statistical programs. My point of view is to maintain the credibility as our hallmark and increase the technical capacity of our students to a level as high as any quantitative specialist in order to compete in the labor market and to have the same opportunities to get the jobs of the financial industry, for instance. A mathematical finance provides a promising job opportunity for young people. In fact, the jobs in financial industry are well paid and in the meantime are scientifically interesting. At the meantime, the mathematical finance show that is necessary to develop new things in statistics that perhaps we have not worked enough in this direction and mathematicians have worked more in this line. For this reason, I say that mathematical finance is a challenge for our profession because it's an opportunity of job, we can develop more, and by now the jobs that I mentioned are occupied by other specialists. Now, turn to modeling the financial market. I put some figures, but the basic model in log scale is simple, the random wall. That means that in log scale, the prices of today are the prices of yesterday plus the innovation. And the innovation are simply normal independent observations. Of course, returns has to be white noise if the model is correct. And clearly, this is more or less true in large period, but when the crisis start, of course, the volatility increase extremely. This is in August 2, when BNP Paribas, a French bank, suspend three of their phones, and this is, of course, when Lehman Brothers go to bring bankruptcy. The basic model is normality, and we are not far away from normality, but of course we have larger observation in details. The basic model is, in statistical words, exactly what I put here, sorry. Returns are exactly normal independent. We can say the same in a more sophisticated way in terms of stochastic differential equations that using the Wiener process we can write the relative increment of prices and this is a geometrical Brownian motion but the two models are exactly the same. at least from a practical point of view. I know that from theoretical point of view, using stochastic differential equations, Black and Scholes get his formula on pricing calls and puts. And however, in continuous time, the model is a complete market. That this only happens in the ideal world, and in discrete times we lose this property, but really in practice the markets are not complete. Of course, we can discuss about what's better to introduce the first the model, like in statistical works or in more mathematical works. For this reason, I take two quotes from Albert Einstein that say that everything should be as simple as possible, but not simple. Of course, it's a question of equilibrium. It has to be simple, but not simple. And as far as the laws of mathematics refer to reality, they are not certain, and as far as they are certain, they do not refer to reality. In a while, in some slices, I will talk a little more on this. But by now, my point of view is try to explain, at least to young people, as simple as possible, in order that more and more people understand what we are doing. Using the simple way, it's easy to modify in order to increase the complexity and to have models more realistic. For instance, in this situation, I put the volatility that depends on time. Then we have to process the white noise that represent epsilons and unorthogonal stochastic processes that are volatilities that, assuming independent of epsilon t and sigma t, we can find a more realistic model that higher kurtosis than the normal, where autocorrelation are zero and square returns has positive dependence. And this is shared, for instance, for GARCH models and other. And the main problem from my point of view is to estimate parameters. But to estimate parameters in this situation, it's really a not easy task because sigma t are random effects. We have two fixed parameters, mu and the variance of sigma t, but also sigma t are unknown. And then from a statistical point of view, this is a model of a random effects model. And why this model is useful? Mainly because if we observe prices in the market of call and put options and try to translate these prices to volatilities, we get what is called the volatility surface. These are prices at the money, and these are under the when the exercise when the price is less than the exercise price, and this is when it's higher. And in fact, we obtain this volatility surface that if we fix t, then we can see the smile that everybody says that the derivative has. If Black-Scholes model was exactly true, then which has to be flat, has to be constant. The volatility has not to depend of time and does not depend of what is called monoinis, that is the exercise price. Of course, this shows that the basic model is not true, even if you write in terms of stochastic differential equations. Of course, in continuous time, there are also Heston model, Hall and White, different models that can explain this, but this can be explained really simple using statistical works. Random effects models face a situation with three kinds of things. One is observed random variables, other are the second are fixed parameters, and the third are unobservable random variables. And from my point of view, this is a not completely solved statistical problem, because in order to do inference under Gaussianity, what is usually done is to consider the marginal distribution. And when the marginal distribution in the Gaussian case, we can compute then this allows us to do inference with fixed parameters. But in order to estimate the random effects, usually we are using empirical bias method. Then there are a mixture of methods using in this situation. There are a third way that is called edge likelihood that was introduced by John Nelder and Yeonjo Lee. And I put this picture because John Nelder died just one year ago. And this is when they introduced the hierarchic likelihood models in the meeting of Royal Statistical Society. And I mentioned also their book on generalized linear models with random effects, when they talk extensively about observable random variable and observable random variable and fixed parameters and how to estimate all these things. Now, finally, I would like to say a little words about what is the reality we face in the finance world. This interview was in July of 2005 and is reported by Inside Job. Perhaps you have seen the movie. And a newswoman make an interview to Ben Bernanke that at this time was he was in the board of federal system, but now he's the chairman of the federal system. And Ben Bernanke was before the chairman of a department in a prestigious university. And I think what explains what happened in Spain and in Ireland and perhaps in other places is exactly this what he say. We have never had a decline in house prices. If you do believe this, then go quickly to buy flats. But this is of course not true. It was not true in this time and is not true now. But if you try in 2005 to say to someone that is not true, everybody thinks you are stupid. However, this happened in Japan 10 years ago and many, many places. But then why we would like so sophisticated models when finally some elementary things like this cannot be rejected? For these reasons, I believe that the core values of service, professionalism, and integrity may be useful in the finance world. By now, we are able to take optimum decisions using 95% credibility. The simplicity of the statistical approach makes the model available to more people, and the asymmetric information probably contribute to the increase of the bubbles. Thinking, for instance, and other specialties, there are Nobel laureate that advocate for one idea and another Nobel laureate advocate for the opposite. In this situation, the credibility is less than 50%. Then I believe that our hallmark is the credibility and we have to use this. Of course, the problem is it's more deep, because in some sense is the problem of the credibility of science in general. We have witnessed the increased situation of the science as business. And when the science become a business, then as Chang Li mentioned in his paper, there are biased incentive that perhaps rewards the false discoveries. And this of course is a problem of all of us. In summary, I would like to say that mathematical finance is a challenge for us because it provides job opportunities for young people. It shows interest in developing more parts of the statistics. I think that the value of the statistics is credibility and that the future of the statistics will depend on today's students. I believe that more mathematical statistic background is needed, and even I believe that we have included mathematical finance for our students. That's all. Thank you very much.